This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Twitch gameplay is a type of video gameplay scenario that tests a player's reaction time. Action games such as shooters, sports and fighting games often contain elements of Twitch gameplay. For example, first-person shooters such as Counter-Strike as well as Call of Duty shooters require quick reaction times for the players to shoot enemies, and fighting games such as Street Fighter require quick reaction times to attack or counter an opponent. Other video game genres may also involve Twitch gameplay. For example, the puzzle video game Tetris gradually speeds up as the player makes progress. Twitch gameplay keeps players actively engaged with quick feedback to their actions, as opposed to turn-based gaming that involves waiting for the outcome of a chosen course of action. Twitch can be used to expand tactical options and play by testing the skill of the player in various areas, usually reflexive responses, and generally add difficulty relating to the intensity of twitching. Required fast chess. Chess played with short time limits between moves is an example of adding a Twitch gameplay element to a turn-based game. Conversely, checkpoints and extra lives are common game mechanics in Twitch gaming that attempt to reduce the penalty for errors in play, adding an element of turn-based gameplay. Traditionally, however, the term Twitch game has been applied to simple arcade, console, and computer games that lack an element of strategy and are based solely upon a player's reaction time. Contents 1 History 2 Gameplay Today 3 Twitch in Shooters 4 References 5 External Links History Twitch refers to the motion the player makes, a sudden movement or reaction to an event on the screen. An early use of the term was by Vern Rabern of Microsoft in 1981. Most early computer, arcade, and console games are considered to be Twitch games. They mostly involved see and react situations. For instance, Kaboom had players rapidly catching bombs that a mad bomber threw from a rooftop. Most classic arcade games such as Space Invaders and Pac-Man were also Twitch-based as games and their control inputs evolved. The games started to favor strategy over reaction, early turn-based games being the most prevalent examples. Such games required players to plan each move and anticipate the opponent's moves ahead of time. Not unlike chess, early strategy games focused on setting pieces and then moving them one turn at a time while the opponent did the same. Many of these games were based on tabletop games. The introduction of the Internet, and its suitability as a playable medium, facilitated many of the features of today's mainstream games. However, that is not to say that all games with a base in strategy do not include room for Twitch gameplay. Soon after turn-based strategy games were introduced, real-time strategy games were introduced to the video gaming market, beginning with Herzog's Way and then Dune 2, and eventually leading to popular titles such as Command. Game contains some level of Twitch, though turn-based strategy games have remained roughly untouched by the phenomenon. First-person shooters remain the predominant genre to emphasize Twitch gameplay. Some games include elements that take players back in nostalgic gameplay in the form of quick-time events or QTEs. These events decide the fate of the player by displaying a keystroke or keystrokes that the player must input quickly. While the concept is not new, the term is often attributed to Yu Suzuki, director of the game Shenmue. Shenmue was an adventure game at its core, and it introduced QTEs as a way to keep players interested during extended cutscenes. Other games have since adopted this method, e.g. Resident Evil 4. Twitch in shooters. Early shooter games were two-dimensional, such as the shoot-em-up Space Invaders, though some had the guise of being three-dimensional, such as the rail shooter Space Harrier. Players operated on a single level with enemies, and with the introduction of three-dimensional environments along with enhanced graphics and network capability, shooters continue to be a major influence in the gaming world. The overall tactics and strategies remained the same. Games such as Quake encouraged fast-paced destruction. Automatic weapons and rocket launchers ensured quick gameplay. It was still a Twitch game, but over time, gameplay success was determined by more than merely having the fastest reactions. As games evolved, additional layers of strategy were demanded over time. Strategy won over Twitch, especially in team and objective-based games. It was soon required that one used skill in order to obtain victory. A primary example of this would be the game Counter-Strike. Even though scenarios can be avoided by taking one's time, even highly skilled gamers still find themselves in Twitch scenarios. In shooters, most are predominantly online, where the actions of the enemy team are unscripted and difficult to predict. Many skilled snipers in these games find themselves twitching when flanked. The instinctual reaction is for one to switch to a secondary weapon, which is most often an inaccurate handgun, and spray fire while attempting to find cover. The predominant reason that shooters do not limit the effectiveness of Twitch scenarios is because the average gamer has little time to actually play the game, especially if they play in online lobbies, with the amount of time the average gamer has to play games limited to between 2 and 4 hours per day. A game that requires a large amount of skill may deter these gamers from playing at all at the same time. Due to the popularity of the internet, there is a large number of gamers who favor Twitch over skill in recent years. Videos have appeared across the internet displaying montages of Twitch in-game kills. Most of these depict players with sniper rifles hardly aiming or not even aiming at all and getting such kills. Traditional 2D shooters have survived in the form of bullet hell shooters, which place a strong emphasis on quick reaction times. References: Carrot Zamora, Ramon, the 13th of April 1981, Olympic Decathlon, the software of Champions, InfoWorld IDG, retrieved the 2nd of August 2015. Light Gun Shoot 'em Up Tactical Survival Action Adventure Grand Theft Auto Clone Metroidvania Stealth Survival Horror Adventure Dating Sim Bishoho Eroge Otome Escape the Room Interactive Fiction Interactive Movie Visual Novel MMOMMOFPS MMORPG MMORTS Role-Playing Game Action Role-Playing Dungeon Crawl Mud Roguelike Tactical Role-Playing Simulation Construction and Management Business City Government Life Simulation Dating Sim Digital Pet God Social Simulation Sports Strategy 4X MOBA Real-Time Strategy Tower Defense Time Management Real-Time Tactics Turn-Based Strategy Turn-Based Tactics Artillery Wargame Vehicle Simulation Flight Simulator Amateur Combat Space Racing Kart Racing Sim Racing Submarine Simulator Train Simulator Other Genres Breakout Clone Exergame Incremental Music Rhythm Non-Game Party Programming Puzzle Sokoban Tile Matching Related concepts Advertising Arcade Game Art Game Audio Game Casual Game Christian Game Crossover Game Cult Game Educational Game FMV Gamification Indie Game Nonlinear Gameplay Open World Nonviolent Video Game Online Game Browser Game Multiplayer Online Game Social Network Game Serious Game Toys to Life Traditional Game Twitch Gameplay Video Game Clone